this darkness is blocking the door. So now I have to deal with an interdimensional noise. Light burns it away, huh? Makes sense.
Made louder. Hartman was stretched like a worm through time. The third thing was a monster. Now we crashed out of darkness toward Faden.
My understanding of the darkness is fragmented, incomplete. This abyss, this void, it very much does not wish to be understood. If light symbolizes knowledge, then it stands to reason that darkness would equate to ignorance. By its very nature, it abhors comprehension. Of course, my own nature drives me to comprehend all. We are opposing forces, destined to collide. And given this conflict of natures, we know that the light of truth will burn away the darkness, both figuratively and literally. Any significant light source can be used as protection, even weaponry against this metaphysical gloom. And then there are the artists. I know for a fact that Tom, Wake, the Anderson brothers, and Lane all had some involvement with the darkness. The question is whether their uncanny ability to affect reality through their art beckons the darkness, or did their work perhaps even create it? With Wake now secure in my lodge, I expect I shall grow closer to learning the answers to these questions. Assuming he cooperates, which is proving quite the challenge. Well, perseverance is the foundation of knowledge. Speaking of, I must be off on my rounds.
Everywhere. New day, same old bloody city, said the old lady. Like tar, but wood for nothing. Get rid of it.
This darkness is draining me. Touches it.
Thank you.
arcade machines. Shoom. Shim? Shoom. Whatever.
Brian Hennerman, 21 years old, resident of Southern Texas.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I really don't understand why I'm here.
You know what you did, Mr. Hennerman.
I do?
Tell me about Delivery Disaster.
The movie? It wasn't very good.
That's not what your review said, but we'll come back to that. Tell me where you got the movie from.
Movie night, with a K, not an N, not night, like nighttime, but...
Who contacted you? Who told you to review that film?
No one. I just did it because it looked obscure. I didn't even like the movie. I shouldn't have given such a high score, but reviewing obscure films makes you look smart. And I thought if I looked smart, I would get listeners. My podcast would take off and I could move out of my parents' basement and maybe even go to college and get a film degree like I've always wanted to. I swear. I swear, I swear, I swear.
Okay, the kid doesn't know shit. I'm ending the session.